My name is David Christensen, and I've been University Carolineur here at UCR for 34 years. I started in 1987 and have been playing weekly concerts and recitals here at UCR during that time. Some of it is original carillon music, written for the carillon. Some of it dates back to the 1600s, the 1700s, and today there's been new music written for the carillon as well. And so I look into that quite a bit. Another area that works very well with the carillon is transcriptions. Transcriptions and arrangements of folk music, pieces from Broadway musicals often work very well. So there's really a large genre of music that can be played on the carillon.
Thank you.
The donors of this instrument were Philip and Dorothy Boyd. And Philip was a regent of the University of California, and he also served in the state legislature. And he felt that this campus should have a carillon, a carillon tower. So I think what happened was he proposed the idea to Ivan Hinderaker, the chancellor at the time, and Bill Reynolds was brought on board. William H. Reynolds was brought on board as the musical advisor for the carillon. And so in his role as the musical advisor, he traveled actually all over the United States, and he listened to various instruments on various campuses, and he finally decided that his favorite bells were from the Picard foundry in France. So that was decided that that particular foundry would be engaged to manufacture the bells for this carillon. And somewhere in the process, as the bells were being completed, he traveled to France and examined the bells and was making sure that they were of the utmost highest quality before they were shipped here to UCR. And I think that we've all experienced the result of that. And so I think we all owe a debt of gratitude for Bill Reynolds, and not only for his work as musical advisor for the carillon, but he did many other things. He was director of the Choral Society. He wrote a book, if I remember correctly, on music theory, and he also directed a church choir, so he was active in the community as well. I actually knew both of them quite well, and Lowell Smith was the very first carillonneur here, and he started in 1966. And he served for 10 years before leaving to go on to actually work in another position outside of music. And then there was 1 year after he left where there was an interim carillonneur, and her name was Patty Ouimet, and she was a graduate student here. So she played for 1 year, and then Margot Halstead was hired as the third carillonneur. And she served for 10 years. And I started studying carillon with Lowell Smith when he was here. And then when Margot was here, I more or less served as an assistant carillonneur, or acting carillonneur if she was on sabbatical or something. And then she left and became the university carillonneur at the University of Michigan. And so later on, after she left, I was appointed as the university carillonneur, and now I've been here for 34 years.